Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let me show you what I discovered when I replaced my USB 2 external drives with USB 3. So if you bought a Mac in the last year or so, chances are you not only have USB on your Mac, you've got something called USB 3. There have been three versions of USB. The first version was a very slow connection that was really good for attaching, say, keyboards and mice and things like that. USB 2 really brought about the idea that you could transfer data across, and a lot of devices, a lot of Macs came with USB 2. But anything pretty recent, and if you look at the tech specs, you'll see that you've got USB 3. So what's the real difference between USB 3 and USB 2? So I recently discovered the drastic difference between USB 3 and USB 2 when I upgraded my Mac Pro. My old one had only USB 2 on it, and I had a couple of USB 2 drives, some USB 2 flash drives, different peripherals that just use USB 2. And when I got the new one, I thought, well, I'll get a USB 3 drive to go along with it, and I was shocked at how much faster it was. Let's look at the Wikipedia page here for USB and see what the speeds actually are. So if we scroll down here, we can see that there's USB 2 and USB 3. Let's jump to USB 2 and we can see that the optimal rate is 480 megabits per second. Now, of course, you can get a little bit lower than that in most cases, but let's use that as a benchmark and then look at USB 3 and see that it's 5 gigabits. So that's more than 8 times the potential speed. And any way you cut it, you're going to get between 5 and 8 times the speed between USB 3 and USB 2. That's quite a dramatic difference when transferring files. Now, when I got my new Mac, I was shocked by how cheap a USB 3 drive was. It really wasn't any more expensive than a USB 2 drive. And drive prices have continued to drop. So it was pretty inexpensive for me to pick up some big USB 3 drives just to give them a try. So I'm going to copy this file here from my internal drive on the desktop into this folder here. And it's going to start copying, and you can see here it's going to take less than a minute. Now, this is an external drive called Archive here. It's a USB 3 drive. This file here is almost 4 gigabytes in size. On USB 2, this would take several minutes, definitely, if not 10 minutes or more. And here you see it's actually going to complete quick enough for me not to have to even skip over it in this video tutorial here. This is the dramatic increase that I saw. And I saw the same thing with Time Machine. I started backing up to a USB 3 drive and I was amazed that I didn't have to even wait overnight for my entire drive to be backed up via Time Machine. It did it in just a couple of hours. Basically the time it took me to go to dinner and come back. And I was really impressed by the speed of USB 3 when I saw it do that. Now you may be thinking, well, wait a minute, there's something even faster than USB 3 on most new Macs, on all new Macs, called Thunderbolt. So why not use Thunderbolt? Get a Thunderbolt drive. Well, the first thing is, of course, Thunderbolt drives are much more expensive than USB 3 drives. So that's one thing, and especially if you're going to do backup, something where it's not really critical, it's just running in the background. Doesn't really pay to spend more money. And if we look at Thunderbolt here, we can get some clue is to the speed of it, 20 gigabits a second, so 4 times faster than USB 3. So right away you're thinking this is the clear winner, except the bottleneck then becomes the drive itself. If you're using a standard hard drive, it's not going to read and write fast enough to keep up with that. You're not going to see a difference between USB 3 and Thunderbolt because the drive will be slower than both. Slightly slower than USB 3, and that speed will then be the same for Thunderbolt 2, so you end up with the same transfer speed. If you're using an SSD drive, well, that's of course much more expensive, so it's a whole different ball game. And then yes, Thunderbolt would make sense. If you have money as no object and speed is what you want, then an SSD drive using Thunderbolt 2 is the winner. But for most people, for backup purposes, for archiving purposes, USB 3 wins out. So basically the point of this video is if you've upgraded to a newer Mac recently and are using USB 2 external drives or even small external thumb drives, you may want to consider going to USB 3, spending the extra money just to get something new anyway, and then using that USB 3 drive there. You'll be amazed at the dramatic difference. It certainly for me was worth every penny, and I've now replaced all of my external peripherals where possible with USB 3 over USB 2.